What if I told you there was a super easy way to decide when to plant, when to weed, and when to fertilize? Then what if I told you that all it took was a little observation of the natural world around you to decide when to do these things? Too good to be true? Not with phenology. And what is phenology exactly? Not to be confused with phrenology, which is the study of the bumps of the skull. Phenology is the study of the timing of seasonal biological activities. While this may sound complex, it simply boils down to things that happen in nature over and over again. These are occurrences like, what time each year do lilacs bud in your area? When do the vultures usually return in the spring? A big one for me is noticing when I start seeing skunks dead on the road, which is unfortunate, but it's then that I know that they're coming out of hibernation and spring is about to begin. The technical term for these natural reoccurring phenomenon is phenophase, and commonly observed phenophases include the leafing and budding out of certain plants. Lilac is a very common one. The migration and nesting habits of birds, and the hibernation, mating, and birthing cycle of animals. Modern phenology is thought to have begun in the mid-18th century in Europe. The phrase comes from two Greek words, phenos, meaning to appear, and logos, meaning to study. So it's essentially the study of appearances, or the time that things appear in nature. But people have been using phenology long before it ever had a fancy name. Ancient cultures relied on nature signs to tell them when to plant, when to harvest, when to hunt, when to look for certain mushrooms, and when to be on the lookout for certain pests and predators. For example, native peoples of the Pacific Northwest would use the ripening of the salmon berries to tell them when the local rivers would be full of the salmon that they relied on for their well-being. In the old world, the common advice was to wait until the apples were in blossom to put your cows out to pasture. Indigenous peoples of British Columbia, Canada, would use the nettles as an indicator for when they could harvest seaweed. Phenology can be a boon for all of us in the modern world, but perhaps we, as gardeners, stand to gain the most from the use of phenology. We can utilize this branch of biology to plan and plant our own garden. And perhaps now, more than ever, this can be useful. With dramatic shifts in weather patterns and unprecedented climate change, knowing how to plant with nature signs could be more useful than any book, blog, or video could ever be. The basic concept is that you use certain phenophases to determine when to tackle certain tasks and when to plant certain seeds, and when to be on the lookout for certain pests in your garden. Quite a few of these have already been well documented. These include things like, the first dandelion blooms indicate that it's a good time to plant potatoes, beets, carrots, cole crops, lettuce, and spinach. The first crocus blooms can tell me that it's a good time to plant spinach or radish. The first daffodil blooms are a good indicator that it's time to plant beets, carrots, chard, and peas. And lilacs budding out indicate it's a good time for beets, carrots, cole crops, spinach, lettuce, cold-tolerant herbs, and hardy annual flowers. Additionally, you can look to forsythia blooming to tell you a good time to fertilize your lawn or to prune roses. Now, I've already captured one of the indicators earlier this spring, and this is a fun one. It's one that I really enjoy. I read somewhere on the internet that when spring peepers start peeping, it's time to plant peas. And that advice seemed to be pretty spot on for me in Ohio. As the season progresses, I'll be on the lookout for several other signs. Daylilies beginning to bloom indicate it's time to transplant peppers and tomatoes. The chicory blooming means I need to be on the lookout for squash vine borers laying their eggs. And this is another one of my favorites. When the oak leaves are the size of a mouse's ear, it's time to plant sweet corn. I've also heard that when it's the size of a mouse's ear, it's time to look for morel mushrooms, which is always a great time of year in our household. With a little time and patience, you can also create your own completely customized planting log. So if you keep track of things that are occurring in your own surroundings, and then keep track of planting dates, you can actually create a log that will tell you exactly when you can look out of your back door and see the first dandelion bloom, for instance, and know that you should be planting radish seed. For example, in my own backyard, I've noticed that the bloodroot, trout lily, spring beauty, purple cress, and cut-leaf toothwort are all in bloom, and the mayapple leaves begin to unfurl about the time that I want to be planting most of my cool season seeds in the garden. There are a lot of great resources out there if you want to start your own phenological record keeping. I'll include them below in the show notes. And I'd love to hear from you. Do you use nature signs to help you with your planning and planting? What are the most reliable indicators where you live? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.